Acromioclavicular, AC, joint osteoarthritis. AC joint osteoarthritis includes degenerative changes in the articular cartilage and other structures in the AC joint, resulting in pain, stiffness, and weakness in the shoulder. The acromioclavicular joint is the point where the distal end of the clavicle meets the acromion. In a healthy joint, the collarbone end and the articular facet of the acromion are covered with slippery cartilage. Although there is a small amount of motion through the AC joint, it plays an important role in shoulder movements such as elevating the arm over the head. Slippery articular cartilage helps to ease these movements. In degenerative AC joint arthritis, the cartilage lining the acromion and covering the end of the collarbone becomes inflamed and damaged. When the articular cartilage degenerates, the space between the acromion and the end of the collarbone narrows and disappears gradually, and the bones begin to rub against each other. Osteophytes may be formed later, which may increase friction between the bones. These osteophytes can rub the tendons and muscles of the rotator cuff, which increases shoulder pain. This condition is known as subacromion impingement syndrome. Causes. Cartilage weakens with age, which is why osteoarthritis in all joints is more common in older people. The kind of work and physical activity may expose the AC joint to small but frequent mini traumas, making it more likely to develop osteoarthritis. As in public vehicle drivers, weightlifting, and painters. Fracture, dislocation, or previous surgery can cause damage to the acromioclavicular joint and eventually lead to osteoarthritis. Symptoms. Activity-related pain. It is vague and may spread to include the shoulder, the front of the chest, and the neck. Laying on the affected shoulder can be painful. As the disease progresses, the pain will continue when you are at rest and will begin to interfere with sleep. The spot where the acromioclavicular joint is, located at the front and top of the shoulder, may feel tender and painful with palpation. Diagnosis. To diagnose AC osteoarthritis, you should answer to your doctor questions about your symptoms and medical history. The shoulder will be examined for signs of previous injury, tenderness and pain points, and muscle weakness. The doctor will observe differences between the affected shoulder and the unaffected shoulder. He will order shoulder X-ray to evaluate your shoulder. X-rays can show narrowing of the AC joint and bone spurs around the joint. It is important to note that some people may have X-rays that show significant signs of acromioclavicular osteoarthritis and experience no pain, while others may have X-rays that show few signs of acromioclavicular osteoarthritis and have significant pain. Treatment. Analgesics and non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, NSAIDs, may reduce pain, swelling, and inflammation caused by AC joint osteoarthritis. Some daily activities and exercise may need to be avoided if they cause pain in the AC joint. You can loosen a stiff AC joint by using warming pad for a few minutes before performing painful movements. Applying ice to the joint for 15 minutes after these movements can reduce swelling and provide immediate pain relief. In contrast to treatment for glenohumeral osteoarthritis, physical therapy is less effective for people who have isolated acromioclavicular arthritis. However, exercises that focus on stretching and strengthening muscles and maintaining the shoulder's range of motion may be helpful. Your doctor may use a stem cell or platelet-rich plasma injections, PRP. These injections may reduce pain and possibly encourage cartilage growth. Anti-inflammatory steroid injections, which reduce inflammation and provide short-term relief. If osteoarthritis symptoms are severe and activity modification and non-operative treatments do not succeed, arthroscopic distal clavicle resection may provide relief. Distal clavicle resection involves removing a small portion of the end of the clavicle, thereby eliminating friction between the clavicle and scapula. Post-surgery rehabilitation. You will wear the sling continuously day and night for at least the first few days. You may remove the sling when you feel comfortable. Intermittent use of the sling may need to continue for 3 to 6 weeks. Begin pendulum exercises, swinging your arm in pendulum-like motions on day post-surgery. You should do 5 times daily exercises. Your doctor will recommend you to start physiotherapy to strengthen the shoulder and improve range of motion 1 week post-surgery. Patient cannot drive until they are off all pain medications and completely out of the sling. Most patients performing sedentary or low-demand work can return to work within 7 to 10 days. Patients performing medium work that may require some light lifting may return in about 3 to 4 weeks. Patients with higher demand occupations will need at least 6 to 8 weeks. Heavy laborers or those with frequent repetitive or overhead work, as in construction, will need a minimum of 3 to 4 months.